Hello, good afternoon, and you're very welcome to the Lanxess Arena in Cologne for the Velux CHF Final Four, second semi-final of the day. If you're just joining us, it is the game between Kiel and Veszprém. Kiel of Germany, Veszprém of Hungary. Earlier on today, Kielce beat Paris Saint-Germain by a scoreline of 28-26 in one of the most physical battles I've ever seen on a handball court. Coming up at 1800 hours Central European time, that's 6 o'clock for all the rest of us, it is Kiel Veszprém, so in about 13, 14 minutes time. But before all of that happens, you know what happens. It is time for another opening ceremony, another opening show before the second semi-final. So sit back, relax and enjoy, and we will rejoin you straight after this.
Dear handball fans, we have a very, very special treat for you now. It's the second opening show, and we like to call it the Acrobatic Interaction Handball Satisfaction. Boo!
Well, the crowd seem to enjoy it.
So let me ask you, I'm ready for the second.
I can't pretend to be a
Are you ready for Keane and Westbrook?
A big fan of modern dance, but you got to say, so the graphics were nice, the music was very relaxing. Well, that's not what I want. I need to be woken up for this second semi-final. We've had one already today. 28-26, victory for Kielce against Veszprém. If you've just joined us, we are now introducing the second semi-final. It is THW Kiel of Germany against Veszprém Handball Club of Hungary. The two referees are from Norway. It is Øyvind Tokstad and Rune Christiansen, and they will take charge of this duel. And let's be honest, it has been a duel for many, many years. One victory for Kiel here against Veszprém, one victory for Veszprém here against Kiel. And that was last season. So, between these two teams, you never know what's going to happen. Let me just remind you, 29-27 to Veszprém in Veszprém, where they met in the group stages earlier in the season, and then 25-24 win for Kiel at home. We are in the Lanxess Arena. We are in Germany. There are a lot of Germans here. Are they supporting Kiel? Well, sounds already like they might be. Land in, introduced to the crowd, followed by Duvniak, the Croatian, very important to this team. Well, he's going to Vardar, I think, next season, Ferreira. But right now, he's a squad player in this Kiel team. Then this man has been unbelievable. I think he said to me, I thought my career was over as a kind of a top-level handballer. But when I got the call, I came back. He was brilliant. He has been brilliant all season. Sprenger, well, he never lets you down. Maybe he doesn't have the pace he once had, but still a player you can depend on when the chips are down to give you something. Only 16 goals in the Champions League. And then in comes Disco Dissinger. 35 goals and a host of injuries this season. And look at Vincek. He's letting everybody know that there's nothing wrong with his knee. And then Niklas Ekberg, first choice right wing, you would think now. 37 goals and the odd time takes the penalties for this team. Igor Anic, great artist. Great artist. And a great vlogger, by the way. You should check out his vlogs. They're very, very good. Then Canellas. It's fits and bursts with Canellas. You never quite know what you're going to get. Then, well, they love him here. Oh, they absolutely adore the boy wonder. Well, if he's the boy wonder, then Dominic Klein's Batman, that's for sure. Now, this guy here, first ever player from Estonia to play in a Final Four. Look how happy he is. And a year's extension to his contract. Now, I don't know about the pants. It's the pants that get me every time with the cat. Look at him coming on. He's a really reflexive goalkeeper. But where's the funny pants? It's Katsigiannis. Then Dominic Klein. Oh, they love him. Oh, and he loves this. This is his kind of arena. This is the stage Dominic Klein loves. He doesn't want to play in any backwater hall. He wants to be here in the Lanxess Arena, followed by a revelation this season, Brozovic, then Vujin, and finally Alfie and his team come out. Peter Gulyas, number three. Alfred Gieselast actually told me that at one stage he was thinking of buying this guy. Said when he saw him at a junior, just shows you how much handball he watches. When he saw Peter Gulyas, he said, oh my God, this guy's one of the best right wingers I've ever seen. But look at the size of him. He's about 2 meters two, playing on the right wing. Then another, followed by another Hungarian, Gergo Ivancic. His brother Tamás left Veszprém a couple of seasons ago. He stayed. Then Timošin Čuk comes on. Another Hungarian, then followed by the Serbian, Momo, big Momo, formerly from Kiel. And would you believe it, formerly of Kiel, Aron Palmason. Roland Mickler came from Szeged to Veszprém, had an amazing season last season, and maybe a Final Four to forget. Then Andy Nielsen came from Hamburg a couple of seasons ago, shares the duties with Sulichin on the line. Ugalde, before him is Nod. Ugalde, who came from Barcelona, won a Champions League with Barcelona back in 2011. Gaspar Marguč. Three brothers in the family, all left-handers, all right-wingers. Then Chema Rodriguez, well, he's won a couple of Champions Leagues himself. Then Mirsad Terzic, they have a serious defensive unit, this team, and he's one of the key pillars of it. Then Mirko Walilovic, the goalkeeper. Sulic, of course, well, he's had two red cards in the last 2 years of the semi-finals. But he's promised me he's going to be a good boy today. Matej Lekoi, from Budapest, but playing in Veszprém. And then Ivan Sliskovic comes on. I rate this guy very highly. I think he's going to be really, really good, Sliskovic. He's only 24, stands 197, 29 goals in the Champions League this season. Well, if you look across, you've also got Zeitz on this Veszprém team, played with THW Kiel. You've got Palmerson and Illich, of course. And then if you look back at the Paris game, you had Omeyer, Karabatic and Narcisse all played. And then, of course, you look at Kielce, they had Reichman played for THW Kiel. So they'd have almost an entire team in the Final Four of former THW Kiel players. Shows what kind of a club it is. Well, the Champions League anthem blares across this arena. 20,000 stuffed to the gills for the second semi-final of the day. And these guys here, everybody says they have no chance. Everybody says it, not me. I'm going 50-50. And not because I want to sit on the fence, but because when these two teams play against each other, it's always special. It's always close. 21 participations in the VeloCHF Champions League for Veszprém, 19 for Kiel. Kiel have won it three times, 2007, 2010, 2013. Veszprém have yet to win. But here's another interesting. Kiel are the only team that will not win their home championship this season. Veszprém have won it, Kiel have won it, Paris have won it. Kiel will not win it. Well, the big question, of course, is always how much the pressure might come on Veszprém, knowing that for the first time, maybe, they're absolute favourites. And teams don't like that. Xavi Sabate is the coach of Alfred Gieslas, I was going to say. Xavi Sabate is the coach of Veszprém. We'll talk about him in a minute. So let's go through the teams again. Landin Katsagianis, the goalkeepers. Dubniak, centre player, so important, 81 goals. Four goals for Ferreira. Mamelund, six goals, but he's a pillar in the defence if he plays. Christian Sprenger, the right winger. Disco Dissinger on the left back position. Vincek, nine goals and only back after a major knee injury. Ekberg in the right wing. Anic filled in the line, probably won't play today. Joan Canellas, his twin brother. Then you have Rune Damke. Janima, incredible story from him. Klein, of course. Brozovic, the line player. And finally, Marco Bouillin. So much depends on Marco Bouillin. If he has a good game, and he's the type of guy that can just decide to have a good game. Xavi Sabate took over from his best friend, has done a great job, won every available title so far. Can he win this? Two goalkeepers, Mikler and Lilovic, then Gujas, Ivancic, right and left wing respectively. Shoot, defence player. Illich can play defence, but mostly attack. Palmerson, what a top-class talent. Nielsen then, number 18. Nodge, number 19, the captain of this team, the heartbeat of this team. Ugalde Marguč, left wing, right wing respectively. Then Chema Rodriguez, serious player. Terzic, Sulic, line player, defence and attack. Defence number two in the right back position, Lekai. Sliskovic, and they brought 71 players, which means Christian Zeitz is the man to miss out. Nothing really, nothing else we can talk about. The referees we know from Norway, Tuksa Christiansen. Here are the star players once again for you. Danish on the left, Icelander on the right, 50 goals for one, and I'd say he saved more than 50 goals. Left Landin, right Palmerson. And as if that wasn't enough, Dubnyak on the left. He is Croatian. 81 goals in the Champions League this season. He's just getting better and better and better and better. And on the right is Dušan Šuk, the specialist defensive player for West Ham. Game is going to start with Kiel in defence, all in white with the gold trim. Referees are ready. It's landing in goal. From the right then, it is Ekberg. Then inside him is Kanellas playing number two in the defensive unit. Then we have Vinček in the middle, Brozovic outside him, Dominic Klein. Look, he needs everybody. Oh, Dominic Klein's winding up his bench already. He's the guy you need in these situations. He's everybody ready. So Dominic Klein and Dubnyak as well, but it looked earlier like Dubnyak was playing in a 3-2-1. That's changed. Left to right for West Brom. Ugalde Illich, Palmerson Lodge, Marguč, and in on the line, it's Andy Nielsen gets the nod, and down in goals, it's Alilovic. So West Brom from left to right, all in red, Palmerson Lodge. And don't expect the tough physical battle we saw earlier. This is going to be a handball game. Nodge, Illich, Palmerson. Oh, and just as I say it, down goes Andy Nielsen in a heap in on the line. And please, says the referee, let's keep it calm. And, well, we don't know what happened, but Andy went down. Dubnyak landed on top of him. Let's look again. There's the little nudge from Brozovic. Ah, there's nothing in that at all. I mean, what's Andy Nielsen doing? That's not like him to throw himself around like that. Well, he's back up and he's ready to go. The other story, of course, is that this Kiel team has nothing else to play for this season. This is all they can win. And if they don't win, they'll be the first team in 13 years in Kiel never to have won any title. Illich over the top, Dominic Klein and Marguč. No mistake, first goal of the game, and Kiel break it instantly. Ball to Dominic Klein, Brozovic with a little fight. Now Dubnyak goes, plays it to Kanellas, put it out, says the referee. Šulić was on like a bolt of lightning, along with Šuk in the defence. Two changes, Nielsen off, Illich on. And Šuk is playing in the centre block with Nodge, just on the left-hand side. Aaron Palmerson comes out to have a little word with Vujan. They seem to be great friends. Here comes Vinček on the wraparound. Ball to Dubnyak, Brozovic is off. Kanellas, Dubnyak, Vujan on. Dubnyak one-on-one with Nodge. Now Vujan, now Nodge, moving them left and right. Great play, up goes Dubnyak. What a goal! And an instant reply, 1:43, and the ball is gone already. Šulić on the line, Illich, Illich, Nodge. Nodge is hit by Brozovic, Brozovic moving left and right. Ball into Šulić, pulled down by Vinček. It's going to be a yellow card, and no more, says the referee. 9-meter ball, Šulić makes his way off. Nielsen makes his way on. Here's the foul. Well, I thought it was before that, actually. I think after that, he hauled him down. He got behind him. But still, with the ball in hand, is West Brom, and it's Illich, Ugalde. Ugalde plays it back. Deep on this near side is Marguč. Here comes the wraparound from West Brom. Nodge to Illich. Here comes Aaron Palmerson, one-on-one with Kanellas. Look at Dubnyak out. And out came Dominic Klein as well. Ball around the back is lost. It's Nicholas Ekberg. Finds his running buddy, Dominic Klein. Scores the goal to make it 2-1. Well, brilliant play already. Nodge all alone with Dubnyak. Comes inside, hits. And the referee is going to give a free hit. I think the Nodge is looking to get that. That was good defence from Dubnyak, I think. Stepped across into Nodge's run. There was the lost ball. Ekberg was gone. And his running buddy, Dominic Klein, great anticipation. No chance, Alilovic, 2-1. Vujanov, Kanellas on. Vujanov, I should say, and Brozovic on. So Brozovic and Vinček in that centre block. 2-1, Xabi Sabate, arms folded. Palmerson arms, or not Palmerson, Gislason arms folded. Illich, the move from Marguč, up goes Nodge. Oh, what a save! Oh, dives headlong. Ball breaks the keel. They start games quickly. Can they last the pace is the question. Kanellas still there. Now Dubnyak. and Brozovic is called ashore. No, they decide to stay with the double line. Well, this is good. They're making the decisions based on what they see. Now the ball is in hand. Now Kanellis. What a ball into Vinček. And look at that. 3-1. First goal. What, three different scorers for Kiel. And West Brom haven't settled. This game ain't over. Believe me. Kanellis. Vinček. Goal. And they stayed with the double line. No change. Brozovic to Vujin. No chance to give West Brom a chance to change their defence. It worked for Kiel. They've a little plan here. Ilić. Palmerson. Save Landin. Rebound Marguč. Marguč to Nodge. Palmerson again. Looks for the little ball around the corner. Something's going on. And look at that. Once Ilić started making that move, they stayed 2-1 against the line player with Nielsen and Palmerson. And Ekberg moved out automatically to stop that pass to Ilić. Great defending. Good movement from Kiel. 9-meter ball. 3-1, 4:17 gone in the game. Nielsen again. Kanellis comes, runs, blocks the run. Oh, he's inside defending no matter what happens here. Nothing. Oh, they got the... He gave him the throw. He missed the throw. Can't believe it. Here's Duvniak. Not going to let go of this ball. Hits the crossbar. No goal. Fast break. Ugalde buries it. 3-2. Well, Duvniak, you just know when he's about to shoot, he does this little, his little shimmy. Well, he hit the crossbar, nice ball, a little bit. And already this game, only 4 or 5 minutes old, is a better game than the other game. Because these two teams want to entertain. They want to play handball, and that's what we want to see. Of course they'll defend. Of course they'll be strong. But not beyond the limit, as it might be. Kanellis, one-on-one with Sulic. Sulic grabs a hold of him. Duvniak, well, easy pass. Second goal for Duvniak. No chance, shoot. Sulic tried to hold on to Duvniak, couldn't do it. Here comes Palmerson. Palmerson, Nodge. Nodge looks great defending again by Vinček. And, by the way, Vujin and Kanellis. No change. Brozovic on the bench. Vujin still on the court. And here comes Andreas Nielsen again onto the line. Between... He goes between Duvniak and Vinček. Reverse pass. Palmerson, Ilić. Poor pass. Stolen by Duvniak. Duvniak looks, finds Vinček. Vinček jumps and scores. Second goal for him. 5-2. Ilić. One-on-one with Kanellis, and Kanellis is defending today. What's going on? Well, maybe they all know that this could be something special, and they're all revved up for it. But of course, as we all know, Kiel is one of those teams that has started strongly here in the last couple of years, sometimes going into 6-goal leads and losing the game. It's whether or not the 7 guys that they have, maybe 8, maybe 9, can actually last the pace. Oh, that's good defending from Klein. And he's going to get a yellow card. Nielsen does really well there, but Klein, watch the way he steps across him. Look at this. Knows the way he's going to turn. And I think that's just about worth a yellow card. Although he hasn't got much choice in it. Look at Nielsen, but he knows which way Nielsen wants to go, and he doesn't let go. Look at this again for defending. Brilliant. Look at the footwork. Nant is getting a player, I'll tell you that. Nant is getting a player. Caution for Dominic Klein, 5-2, Kiel lead. 6:45 gone of the game. And it's the eye of the tiger from the Kiel guys at the moment. Palmerson, Ilić, off the defence and over for a corner ball. And the entire Kiel bench stands and applauds their teammates. Nodge, Palmerson, oh, Brozovic! What a terrible tackle, Brozovic. That is shocking. And there's absolutely no reason for it. He's a good player, but he does things like this, and really no need for that at all. Well, Vinček, he beats him easily, but what does he need to do that for? He's already through. No need for that push. It's a 7-meter ball, correctly so, and a power play now, and he's got to be cool, Brozovic. Here comes Ilić, does his little shuffle, plants the foot, facing Landin, and buries it past Landin. And he faked him, first goal for him, faked him first, but the speed with which he took the shot was incredible.
Best bet oh. score, whoa. 5-3 by player number 13, Momir.
But you can see Landine's done his homework. I can see him saving a penalty today. He went and he knew that's the way he goes next time, and he was almost there. Well, what is Gieslassen? I've never seen him play a libero in 7 years of watching Kiel. And against Barcelona, he played it for the first time, and he's playing it here today. Dominic Klein, libero, off he comes. Ball, reverse pass. Now, Canellas, he's trying to come outside. There's something going on. It's Gaspar Marguch. Takes the yellow card. And Duvniak calls it again with Canellas. Nobody home for Kiel. 6-on-5. Here comes Vincek, Canellas. Canellas one against one. He's held up. He does that all the time. Looks for the foul. And now you see Vujin take the little bouncer and maybe the shot in the end. No, it's Canellas goes for an easy save. A Lilovic. Palmerson, lovely ball. Marguch. Marguch is gone. Marguch is gone. He is fast. Second goal for him. And it's 5-4. So the power play working for Westman. And Xavi Sabate steps into the hot seat. Assistant coach for a few years. Steps in. He's won every title. And he doesn't... He doesn't panic because Kiel goes into a big lead. He just plays it calm. 17 seconds left. Libero again is Dominic Klein. Makes the move. Now comes back off. Here comes Canellas. Now Duvniak. It's Vincek getting pushed and shoved around in there. Centre block is doing its job. Centre block for Westman at the moment is Illich and Nodge. Now Dominic Klein comes off. On again, but this time not as the libero, because the power play is over. Hand is up for passive play. Vujin takes it to Duvniak. Duvniak to Ekberg. Ekberg to... Yeah, took too much out of it. And then Canellas nearly takes the head off his own player. And Vincek makes nothing of it. Although that kind of reminds me of the pass from Vale Jalouse to Gudjon Vallar, which really did nearly take his head off. Here we go. Nice block, down. Nice block, Paddy. 5-4, 9.5 minutes gone, and the minutes are flying by in this game. Brozovic back onto the defence alongside Vincek. Got to say, Vincek, top guy, was really coming good. And then his cruciate ligament went, but he's come back earlier. Brilliant ball. Palmerson Illich took the entire defence with them. Paddy couldn't get his footwork right. Second goal for Illich. First one, a penalty, of course. That's the ball that makes it. And then no chance, Brozovic or Canellas. 5-5. I think Kiel would have taken this at the start of the game. 10 minutes gone. But the West Brom defence just seems to have settled ever so slightly. The 2 minute suspension cost Kiel dearly. Here's Vujin, held again, this time by Ugalde, who comes out in that 5-1 that they sometimes employ. Schuch hits Vujin. Canellas to Duvniak. And Sulic. Oh, Dominic Klein goes for a shot, probably wasn't on. Maybe getting a little bit too carried away. Aaron Palmerson controlling the game. Nodge to Illich. Illich comes all the way across. Now Palmerson to Nodge, and Sulic is called ashore once more. I think the West Brom defence is being very clever here. They're almost forcing the referees to call passive play. They're coming out in that kind of aggressive formation. And the referees called their passive play twice, quickly on Kiel. Block again by Nielsen. Up goes Nodge. Now bounces and now turns. Nothing, says the referee. It's going to be a 9-meter ball. And the game just entering a little bit of a lull. Kiel came out of the blocks quickly. West Brom responded. It's parity 5-5. Everything is status quo. Palmerson goes again. Off the post this time. Canellas is fouled. He looks, he finds. And Vujin looks, what does he do? Goes one against one and takes the shot. And Illich takes a yellow card on his own countryman. Hey, buddy, how's it going? I don't think I've ever seen Vujin move that fast. Oh, look at this, though. Great save from Landin there. Landine at 38% now, and Lilovic at 29%, but it doesn't really matter. It's 5-5. Brozovic in on the line. Bujin, Kanellas, Duvniak playing in the back division. Still no sign of Rune Damke. I doubt, the way Dominic's playing, doubt we'll see much of him. Ball to Duvniak, hit by Nodge, goes again. Great shot and save, but a yellow card for Nodge. Yeah, yellow card for Nodge for this.
Yellow card.
There we go. And Dominic goes in second line of the far side. Kanellas, Vujin, well, he takes a shot that maybe wasn't on, but how quickly did Ilic get out of him? Ilic was out of 11 metres. Just as Marco Vujin is thinking of taking a shot, suddenly Momir Ilic is right on top of him. Duvniak fouled by Sulic. Another two Croatians having a little word with each other. Kanellas, one-on-one with Nodge. Doesn't work out now. The line's open. That's beautiful! Oh, Vujin's got to score that. It opens up. Oh, blocked by Dominic Klein. Well, that's incredible. Very rare you see that. On comes Mamelund in place of Vujin. Now it's Palmerson. Brozovic is in trouble again here. He's got to be careful because Palmerson has targeted him as somebody to go one-on-one against. And he had his arm there. Sulic stays in on the line. Mamelund now defending in there with Brozovic. Maybe a calmer head. Vincek, they're not risking that knee. Can't play 60 minutes. Marguč, Nodge. Palmerson, Ilic, Ugalde still deep. Ilic. Nodge loses it behind the back. Here he goes again. Now ball to Ilic. Ilic blocked. Rebound is nobody's. Oh, it is. It's a 9-meter ball for Vespem. Andy Nielsen back onto the court again. And the move is called. Everybody knows what they're going to do, and Dissinger is getting ready. Here goes Nodge, blocked and out over the end line for a corner ball. So Christian Dissinger, Disco as Gislason calls him, is ready to come on. Aaron Palmerson around the corner to Nielsen. Great defending from Erlend Mamelund. That's amazing, because Aaron Palmerson loves that. He knocks on the door and then around the corner places that ball, and Nielsen loves playing with him. Brozovic high, Palmerson! 6-5, and he's as happy as Larry. On comes Šuk, on comes Sulic. First goal of the game for Aaron, 6-5 in total. And look at that. Well, Landin has beaten him the near post.
Time to six.
Alfred not happy with that one.
Number 14.
Duvniak, Dominic Klein getting a bit of shirt pulled off him, really. And the timeout is called between Brozovic and Sulic. Now, Brozovic is already under 2 minutes. Well, that's like the young bull having a word with the old bull, isn't it? Sulic is the old bull, by the way, in case anybody's wondering. And they're having a little fight. Normal, and the referee steps in and says, OK, boys, enough, let's play ball. 6-5, almost 15 minutes gone in the first half. Dissinger, Duvniak, well, what was he thinking there? Ball breaks to Brozovic, ball to Dissinger. Oh, someone had his arm. Oh, trouble here. Someone had his arm. Someone gives him a push. It's Šuk. Off he comes for 2 minutes. That's good play, Dissinger. Oh, that's a terrible foul by Šuk. No need for it. Absolute. His duty of care to Christian Dissinger there just discards it completely. And it's a power play now for Kiel. 6-5 down. And they have a movement with a double line that would frighten the life out of you. They're just not doing it here today. Right, at least not at this moment. Here's the ball to Dissinger. Dissinger to Vujin. Oh, held up again. Penalty, says the referee. And 2 minutes again. Well, we've seen this before from Vespram. A player down. They lose another player. Well, Kiel's got to score two or three here, right?
2 minutes suspension.
Nice sidestep. Good block, Brozovic. And actually, they got the wrong guy. It was Momir had his arm around him. Ekberg takes the penalty, facing Alilovic. Penalties have not been Kiel's strong suit this season. Fakes one. Now he scores it, 6-6. Ooh, just under the leg. Just under the leg. And coming back, Dominic Klein says, are we playing six? But look at the press. Look at the press there. Out to 9 metres. Out to 9 metres and moving together. Here comes Margucci. Look, he's not even allowed into the 6 metre line. They are pushing them out. Now Palmerston, remember, there's only four of them playing against six. This is a double power play. Palmerston, nowhere to go, and he's screaming at his other players. One-on-one, no. Gives it to Ugalde, now to Illich. Illich to Palmerston. What's he going to do? Goes for the shot, easy save. Fast break, here comes Brozovic. Here comes Ekberg. He waits, plays it to Vujin. Ah, just opens up for Vujin. He had the time to just stand there, look around, and his first goal of the game. 7-6, two-goal turnaround, and that two-minute suspension is after causing heartache and pain for Vespem. 1 7-metre scored, one fast break counter-attack scored, and look at this, it's time to just stand there, look around, and Marguč, well, he's got no chance. And here they come again, four monsters on the 9-metre line, waiting for the red of Vespem to come anywhere near it. Now Illich, one against one, and he's hit by two. 15 seconds left and a timeout called by Xavi Sabate. First to blink is Vespem, losing 7-6, but four players playing six. Let's listen to what he has to say. What? Well, the timeout's been called. 7-6 for Kiel. And there's Dula just making sure he's awake. He's such a special player. He's one of those guys, comes along maybe once in a blue moon. A little bit like Karabatic. They just have all the strength, all the athleticism to be a great handball player, even though stylistically they don't look that good, but they're just forces of nature. Illich, Palmerston. Palmerston one-on-one with Mamelund. Mamelund misses him, Brozovic stops him. How do you defend 6-4, like Kiel are doing right here? And they won't want to let another goal in. Here comes Šulić now, only 11 seconds left, handles up a passive play. Šiškovic on the right. Oh, he runs straight into trouble. Mamelund has it. Mamelund to Duvniak, and they haven't recovered yet. Vesprem. What will Christian Dissinger do? Goes for the early shot, knowing they're not quite recovered in defence. They are now 6-6 on the court, but a two-goal turnaround for Kiel. Dissinger, all blocked, and he's down. It's 2 minutes again for Shu. Well, he must have really nailed him in midair, because I thought it was a good block, but something else must have happened after that. Now, the referees have decided it's only 2 minutes. Number five, 2 minutes, they've decided. Second 2 minutes of the game. But Christian Dissinger, well, I heard the bang, which is why I looked around. Looked to me like a block initially. Yeah, a good block. Oh, it was the block with Šliskovic. I didn't actually see Šuk from my angle. And what is he doing? I know, why is he doing that, though? He's on a two-minute suspension for a really bad foul just earlier. Look at this. Oh, that's a terrible tie. That could be a red card. Put the two of them together, even though he's only on two minutes. That could easily be a red card for Šuk. And he seems to be losing his head in the game. And Dissinger, well, he's been in the wars. They obviously have targeted him as somebody who's very dangerous for the Kiel team. He's been great this season. But do you take him out of a game? He is winded, that's for sure. All he's got to do is lie down and get a bit of air into his lungs. He looks like he's been hit by a tank. Right. Another power play. Brozovic on the wraparound. Ball to Vujin. Vujin, ball to Kanyenyas. Back to Brozovic. He's fouled. Nothing since the referee. Ilinovic doesn't see Sulic. Oh, Dominic Klein almost saw Sulic and almost won the ball, but not quite. And Sulic scores his first goal of the game against the head. And really, the 6-on-5, it was over. They over-elaborated on it. And Sulic, Ilinovic could have seen him first time. But luckily enough, he got the ball second time for Veszprém. 7-7, 1:36 left on the power play. So they are going to go for the... They are going to go for the double line play, which worked. Well, every single time they played at 6-on-5 against Barcelona, they got a goal. Every single time. It was incredible. So what happens is Brozovic comes this near side, and watch where Vincek stands next in. And that means that the defence has to... Ilic can't make the decision of who to come for. Here's Kanyelias. Kanyelias, lovely ball. Save. No, the referee's got to be a penalty. It's got to be a 7-meter. Doesn't give it. Vincek hauled down. But the referee doesn't give it. And it worked again. And under normal circumstances, it's a goal. Great save from Ilinovic. Here it is again. Lovely ball. No, great decision from the referees. I apologise for my angle. Looks like he's got his arm, but Vincek is free, 7-7. 57 seconds left on the power play, and it is Gulyas who's on as the libero. Now the movement, a bit over-elaborate from them too. Lovely ball in. Sulic gets a little shove from Vincek, and Vincek is off. Push, says the referee. Here it is again. Vincek steps out. Well, I thought it was Vujin the first time. It was Vujin should have got the 2-minute suspension. There's the push, but Vincek gets it. And when I saw it first, I said, what did Vincek do? He just stepped out. But it was Vujin who pushed him. So it's 5 against 5, and it's 7-7. 20 minutes gone in the game. And, well, neither team can pull away from the other, that's for sure. Palmerson. Ball that steps, if you ask me, but Ilic buries it. Same old, and the same old result. Third goal for Momir Ilic, 8-7 Veszprém. Now look at this. Here's the first step from him. That's steps in my book. That's four steps, and he doesn't get called on it. But you can't fault the pass to Ilic, he was incredible. Kanyelias, Vujin hit by Nodge. Kanyelias is down. 3 seconds left on the Veszprém 2-minute suspension. Here comes Sliskovic. Kanyelias goes alone. Fouled, and it's a 9-meter ball. Well, they're 6 now. Sliskovic in the centre block alongside Nodge. They're not playing shoot there anymore. Ekberg getting a little bit of... up goes off Duvniak. Now, he's no right to score that goal. It's his third of the game. But my goodness me, he just finds a little gap somewhere. And that's it. In it goes, 8-8. 20 minutes gone. Palmerson calls it again. Gulyas now on the right wing. Ugalde stays on the left. Here comes Nodge. Here comes Ilic. Up they go, and in it goes. So simple. Fourth goal for Ilic. The little parallel pass. He's already moving. They close the gap between them. And Brozovic and Kanyelias can't make it over. That is super simple. Look at the movement off the ball. Ilic coming on to it. Perfection. It should be in every coaching manual. How to do it and how to make it work. And it just shows you, 6-on-5, you don't have to be elaborate, you just have to be good. Duvniak, well, Ugalde almost wins it from him. He's holding on to him. Referee decides that's 9 metres, it's 9-8. And now a timeout called just as the Kiel suspension is over. Let's listen to what Alfred has to say.
Key jump and let's go to pass. and let's go to find one good option always. Okay? Hey! Let's go, bye! Hey, hey, hey.
Well, I think that you might see Keel now closing that 6-0, pushing them wide, make them make the extra pass, get the ball out to the wings, and let's see how Landine does against the likes of Guyash particularly, who maybe Alfred thinks is not as good as Margouche on the wing. Ugalde, well, he can have an off day, of course.
We have 9 minutes.
So, let's see, does it work? He wants him to close the centre anyway, but there's Zilic, 4 goals in the game, and everyone a doozy.
All the fans from Tiami Kiel, all the fans from Mestre, clap your hands!
Well, it starts again, Canellas in the centre, Vujin in the right back, haven't seen much from him, Dissinger comes back in the left back position, Vujin, oh, nice movement. Nice goal, second goal for Vu Yin, but it was nice movement, it was crisp passing, and it was more or less the same move, just a bit more elaborate. Up goes Zilic, now Nodja, what a save! Rebound is Kiel's. Dissinger, Brozovic, Dissinger, almost dead, nothing in the end. Canellas, held by Nodja and by Zilic. Ball comes back out to the 9-metre line. Brozovic, well, I know that Alfred rates him very highly. He said he's much better than I thought he was. Great trainer. He trains really hard and he plays really well. He said he's been a really good addition to the team. That's Brozovic, of course. Now, here's Ekberg. Here's Vinček. Oh, he's hit, but he scores. Paddy Vinček, another nice goal from Kiel. Well worked. I mean, just watching this game, you can already see how much coaching goes into the concept of playing attack. It's very rare. If they do go one against one, it's because they've worked it, so the guy has left one against one, and that's beautiful to see. Now Kiel take the lead again. There really is nothing between these two when they play. Guyash Nodge, Palmerson, Illich, Palmerson. Nodge, here comes Illich again. He's up again, but it's saved. It wasn't the best shot this time. Rolls out to Paddy, plays it to Landine, ball to Dissinger, all the way over to Canellas, and Vinček is told to come off, and the high tens Duvniak, and on comes Vujin in the right back position. 2 goals for him and a bit of movement finally. Well, the crowd has just ratcheted up the volume. Same movement again, Dissinger again. Oh! Third time, three different variations of the concept. 3 goals. Unbelievable to watch. 11-9. The game turns on its head again. Same movement. Beautiful. Opens up. This time they go with Vu Yin. And this time, oh, well, it just shows you. When you train hard, that's what you can do. Right, can Vespren find an answer? Of course they can. Here comes Nodge. Nodge goes up. No, plays it. It's a lovely ball to the wing. Gaugalde makes no mistake. Ugalde scores it. Second goal for him, 11-10 the score. 21 goals in 23 minutes of handball. And handball is being played. What a ball. Absolutely nailed Ekberg out there through the legs. Here it comes again. Here it comes again. Palmerson steps out this time. Brozovic was free and didn't realise it. Opens up for Vujin, who's nailed on the way through. And the referee gives a nine-metre ball, but Vujin's in trouble. Somebody came out. Was it Vujin? Yes. Somebody came out and absolutely, well, the only word is they creamed him. Watch this again. Oh, it's Zilic. Oh, my goodness me. That is 2 minutes every day of the week. He comes in with the hip. Boom. Oh, my goodness me. And I think Vujin's actually hurt himself there, whatever way he landed, maybe.
6 seconds left of the first half. Lexus Arena, clap your hands.
I think he's going to be okay. He's back in his position again. And I think they're going to go for it again. This time on the other side. Dominic Klein, Vujin. Here comes the ball to Dissinger. Dissinger to Canellas. Canellas slows it down. Now the ball's played. But the referee had already called a 9-meter ball. Seems to be more effective with Ekberg. Oh, breakthrough! Pound, 7 meters. Have you ever seen Vu Yin play like this? Can I tell you a story? He used to play for Vesprem. Now, watch the way he sidesteps. I've never seen that. Well, I haven't seen it in 4 years. That is Marco Vuillin trying to show his old club, hey, I've still got it. Ekberg against Alilovic! Lobs it in! You gotta love it! And Alilovic stands at 2 meters tall, up and down. Oh, he's waving at it, isn't he? The ball comes down with a bit of snow on it into the back of the net. 12-10, 25 minutes gone in a beautiful game of handball to watch. Chema on in the centre with Šliskovic. Šliskovic comes second. Oh, the hit from Vícek. Brozovic comes late. He's got to be careful. Great goal from Nodge. First goal of the game from him. It just came from a double switch. Just moving from Vesprem. Oh, Vícek goes down. Nothing, says the referee. No, says the referee. Šulić is saying the same. But then, of course, Šulić always says the same. Oh, Šulić. Well, the referees have got a look at that. Oh, that's terrible. Well, I mean, the referees could have gone over and had a look at the instant replay there if they felt there was something, but they completely missed it. Dissinger, Canellas, here comes Ekberg. Ball to Dissinger. Out comes Terzic now, who's on defending. Let me give you the rundown again. From left to right, Ugalde, Terzic, Šliskovic, Nodge, Šulić and Chema. That's who's out there. Here's Canellas. Canellas to Disco. He's lost it. Oh, he gets the rebound. Ball to Vuillin. Vuillin goes one on one. Oh, my goodness me! What? Marco Vuillin absolutely out of nowhere. Third goal of the game. 13-11. And in goes Chema, 9 metres, says the referee. And off comes Marco Vuillin. Who is this man? Look at this, facing Šliskar. Oh, he goes over him. And then, how on earth does he score this against Alilovic? That's unbelievable. They're all playing 10% better than they've ever played in their lives. Well, I think Vuillin's looking to stay on there. It's the Final Four. You're absolutely right, Carson. It's the VeloCHF Final Four. And Kiel just love being here. But so does Vesprem. And they've tasted the final. They're not giving in, that's for sure. Chema, one-on-one. Ball lost. A lot of bodies in my way over there. So Ekberg does his job. Canellia still defending in the number two. Brozovic, Vincek. He's really mixing up his pack, Xavi Sabate, for the Vesprem team, but so is Alfred. They're going to be fresh in the second half. Chema, Nodge. Nodge, Šulić. Got to be a 7 metres. Yeah. Inside defending from Canellas. What a ball from Nodge to Šulić. But you've got to give it to Šulić. You could have had a red card down the other end. But look at that block. And look, he pulls Canellas with him. Clever play from the line player. That's experience. Here comes Ilić. Ilić facing Landin. Oh, Landin saved it. Told you he was working on it. He knows if he does this, he does this. If he does something else, then the second fake it goes here. Landin saves it, 13-11. Fake one way. Oh, straight at him. Well, he didn't really have to do too much in the end. But they all count. Landin, 39%. Alilovic, 24%. There's the save again. Well, suddenly, it appears that the arena is full of Kiel fans. They've just popped up out of nowhere. It's like that movie Spartacus, where everybody claims to be Spartacus. Everyone's suddenly saying, hey, I'm actually a Kiel fan. Here we go. Dissinger goes alone, bounces, goes again. Foul, says the referee. Good defence by Terzic, I think it was, who followed him all the way around. Disco comes back out to this left back side. Duvniak in the centre. Dominic Klein goes in. He's absolutely getting the jersey ripped off him by. And the referee says nothing to Chema. He's got to be seeing that. Here's Chema. Goal. The same guy that should have maybe had. Well, at least a warning down the other end. One goal for him. Nothing is said. And it's unbelievable that a referee can miss that kind of short tugging in on the line. Great goal by Chema. How often has he done that? He just takes a basketball style down the court and he scores. 1 minute 45 seconds left in the first half. Kiel just in the lead, 13-12. Duvniak, ball to Vuillin. Vuillin to Dissinger. What a turn! What a turn! Šulić had no answer. He just drops the shoulder. Milner, second goal for him. He sees Sulic coming and he's already dropped it. Watch this. Ah, oh, you didn't see it, unfortunate. The goal was made before the goal was scored. He just turned them so quickly. Brilliant. 14-12. What's the answer from West Brom? Guya still deep to the right. Nodge, Chema. What a centre player he is. Come back from a tight tear. Ball into Sulic. Lost. And Sulic is claiming Vincek was inside. I think he's got a bit of a point. But Vincek let go of him. And it was a poor pass. Here we go again. Ball to Chema. Chema's called it with Sulic now on the line. He's going to come on the wraparound. No, he's staying over that side deep. Now here comes Guyash. Oh, they've lost it. That's unbelievable. Ball over the top is to Dissinger. And that's great refereeing, I have to say. You know, Dissinger has no chance to see a ball coming over his shoulder. Poor pass by Dominic. And Chema tries to buy the attacker foul. Well, Chema's got me. Dissinger's no chance. And the referee's right to call that and tell Chema to give it up. That's a great decision. How often do we see attacker foul given there? It just seems like the obvious decision. Well, they're sitting in wonder, wondering, how on earth are we not winning this game? We came here with the best squad, the best team, and suddenly these guys in white, who are they again? THW Kiel, they're beating us 14-12. 20 seconds just over remaining. Here's Vuyin, Dissinger. Vuyin, no way! No way! No way! I can't believe it in the middle of a game! In the Velux EHF Final Four! Fourth goal, Dubniak, and they go for a Kemper. 5 seconds off the post twice. No rebound. It's goalie's ball. It's a three-goal lead on the Kemper. Can you believe it? Talk about entertaining the fans. That is unbelievable. He has got a lot of work to do in the second half, Xavi Sabate, because this Kiel team is playing with freedom. Because they don't care. It's like they think, no one thinks we have a chance. The body language from them from the very start looked very, very strong. Look at it again. Here's the switch. And look at that. No chance, Sulic. And oh, Lilovic nearly got it. But goal it was. And that is why you watch handball. To watch that type of play. Strong defending right. Of course, there are some 2 minutes. But not the fight we saw earlier, which was ultra defensive, albeit it scored 28. It finished 28-26. You can see this game going 36-34, which is what you want to see. Entertain the crowds. It's been brilliant. Kiel has been brilliant. Let's have a little look at some of the stats from the first half. 15-12, of course, the score. 63% scoring for Kiel, but they do take a lot more shots, that's for sure. 40% saves for Landin, good change. 21% for Mikler, for Alilovic, they have Mikler. Now, turnovers is 4-3, so there's nothing there. And suspensions is only 3-2. And goals a man extra. Look what they can all do. Amazing. It's been, I have to say, that has been one of my favourite halves of handball all season. And I've seen a lot of games this season. Duvniak on 4, Ilic on 4. Then it's Vincek and Vuyin on 3s. Then it's 2s and 1s all the way down. The second half is 13 minutes and 20 seconds away. It's going to be a doozy. Do not miss it. We will be back with you right on time for the second half in the second semi-final, the Velux EHF Final Four between THW Kiel and West Brom Handball Club of Hungary. Rebuild the playgrounds and provide training to give them the right to play and the tools to change.
Exactly, that's perfect. So, are we ready for the music? Outside the circle.
Well, we rejoin you for this, the second semi-final in the Velux AHF Champions League, with Kiel playing Veszprém in the Lanxess Arena in Cologne. 20,000 strong, the arena, and it is Kiel with a three-goal lead, 15-12. Their body language at the start coming out just looked like a team that said, hey, we're not going to lie down. But one thing you can be sure of between these two teams is nothing is ever decided until the final minutes of the game. How often have we seen it between them? A goal here, a goal there. That's all it takes for one to defeat the other. Three goals down at the moment. This Veszprém team will be hurting in the second half. It is Kiel starting with the ball, a chance to go four to the good. They're playing from left to right in the all white strip. And if I can just... they're still doing the kiss cam and whatever else in the stadium while we await the referee's whistle. The Veszprém team is ready in defence. It's Mickler takes over in goal. And it's interesting that bottom left in the first half against Alilovic, 4 from 4. Bottom right, 6 from 6. So the old adage, shoot low, score high. 10 goals from 10 for Kiel shooting low. The defence of Veszprém is Marguč inside him in number 2. Palmerson, then Nodge and Schuch in the centre block. Then Terzic, and then on the left wing is Gergo Ivancic. And it's interesting that Sulic is not there on the in the defence. Maybe the coach realised that he was very close to...
Let's prepare for the second half of the semi-final number 2.
Maybe he thought that it was a long... maybe he thought that Sulic was... in a bit of trouble, but it's a long way for him to be substituted on and off if he's not playing defence and attack. Now, Kiel start. Dominic Klein-Dissinger, who's had a great first half. Dubniak Vujun, who's also had a great first half. Ekberg on the right wing. Vincek on the line. Here comes the first movement, and it's the same movement. Here comes Vujun. Ball over the top to Dubniak. Dissinger goes, ball to Vujun, Vujun, Dubniak, Dubniak looks for the wing, finds Dominic Klein, back to Dubniak, hits the post and out over the sideline. Veszprém ball, so no, doesn't make it 4, and it's Nielsen and Illich who come on, and Illich immediately into the action. Palmerson, Nodge, Nodge 1 against 1, tries to turn, can't do it. 9 metre ball and travelling, says the referee, which is why it wasn't more, or he didn't allow him to take the shot. Ball comes out, Nielsen on the line, Illich in the left back position. That's the switch for Terzic and Schuch. But certainly at some stage we'll see Sulic coming on to the court on the line. Absolutely sure about it. But maybe a long way for sure, but maybe the coach felt that Sulic was walking a thin line. Maybe he saw that he was getting a little bit aggressive, maybe overly so, and decided a break was good for him. Here's Nodge and Illich. Here comes the wraparound from Nielsen. Old move. What can they do? Palmerson one-on-one with Brozovic. Goes alone. Ball into Nielsen. Nielsen. Shot. Saved by Landin. And it is a 7 metre ball. Looked like he was giving a free throw. Brozovic cannot be left one-on-one. Inside defending from Dissinger. Brozovic can't be left one-on-one with Palmerson. Palmerson's done it again. That's who he's targeting. So Marguč steps forward to make it a two-goal game. 15-12 the score. Marguč against Landin. Remember, Illich missed the last one, and he scores this one. But Landin very close to it. 3 goals for Marguč in the game. And Alfred...
15-13, scored by Gaspar
Marguč. Just over the arm. Landin goes down very quickly. Very, very quickly. Just a ball over him can beat him. Vujun, wrap around from Vincek. Vujun, onto it comes Dissinger. Reverse pass to Dubniak. Now, second line is Ekberg. Here goes Dubniak. Ball to Dissinger. Oh, it's just wide of the post. They say it got a touch on the way out. It certainly didn't. It was just wide of the post. You could see what he was trying to do. Wrap his arm around the defender. Nodge, Palmerson, Palmerson, Illich. Illich. Oh, Brozovic is in trouble again. No, he's not. I cannot believe that. I mean, he's all over his back. That is a 2 minutes every day of the week, and he's already on a 2 minutes. Brozovic is to be careful, really careful. Nodge, Illich, Nielsen, here's Brozovic, one-on-one again with Palmer. So no, he gives it to Ilić. Now he is. Look at that. Oh, the shot, the little block this time from Brozovic. Ball breaks quickly. Dominic Klein to Duvniak. Duvniak, he's got Ekberg open. Ekberg doesn't fancy it. He does now. No, he goes one-on-one with Gergo Ivancic. Can't break through. Great play from Gergo Ivancic. On comes Vujin in place of Brozovic. Nice block from Brozovic that time. Surprise, Palmerson didn't take him on again, one-on-one. But Dissinger, Duvniak, Vujin. That's the back line of Kiel. The noise in this arena is incredible. Vujin up and down, plays it on. Now Duvniak, one-on-one with... Oh, he's lost it. Great defence now, diving the ball. Vujin, Nielsen gets it, plays it. It's Nodge all alone with Dissinger. What a save! Oh, rebound, Palmerson. Oh, brilliant! Dominic Klein just maybe didn't believe. What a save, Dissinger. Second goal for Palmerson. And Dominic had it, and it was pickpocketed by Palmerson. Do we see it again? Oh, he had it, he lost it, and Palmerson got it. 15-14, and the three-goal deficit. What an initial save. Look at that. Had his pocket picked by Palmerson. And Palmerson, well, nearly took Landine's head off on the way past him, but it's 15-14. And West Brom right back in it. The three-goal lead dissipates, and it's West Brom who've come out the stronger team of the second half. Terzic and Šuk, 2 and 3 on this side. Vincek, Vujin. It's now Kanellas, Duvniak in place of Dissinger's Kanellas. Now Vujin, one-on-one with Nodge. Look at Nodge, just pushes him out. Nah, it's brilliant. What can he do? Nothing. Great defence from Terzic. Absolutely brilliant defence from Terzic to keep him at bay. 15-14, 4 minutes 12 seconds gone in the second half. Kiel hasn't scored. West Brom has scored 2. Oh, they've lost it again. They've lost it again, and Kanellas wanted a foul there and didn't get it. Well, the referees are missing some strange things, but... maybe they feel the game just his arm was free. He could play the ball on, and Kanellas does that. He plays for the foul. Didn't get it that time, and a chance for West Brom to equalise here in the game. Nodge, Palmerson, West Brom reverberates around the arena. Here comes Nodge. Nodge, open the wing. Oh, great defence from Ekberg, who then tries to turn Gergo Ivancic. Ball breaks quickly to Kanellas. Kanellas breaks it quickly to Duvniak. Duvniak on to Vujin. Great save, Mikler. They went deep. I think that's the first time they've saved it deep, but it was Mikler. They've lost the ball. No, over the sideline off a Kiel hand. And the ball breaks quickly to Palmerson. Palmerson all the way to Ivancic, who's hit on the way through. Referee's going to call someone here. I think it's Ekberg. Is it Vujin or Ekberg? It's Vujin. Well, he's unlucky there. Ivancic wraps his foot around his leg. And that's a 15-15 and a power play now for West Brom. Three-goal turnaround, and Janima, the Estonian, makes his appearance at the Velux CHF Final Four. Congratulations, Estonia. Great to see. And it's the libero is Ekberg. Here comes Dominic Klein. What can he do? Plays it to Janima. Janima sidesteps Terzic. Terzic holds on. Janima has a little word with him. Janima, a little wry smile. Holds on to the arm. Look, takes Terzic with him. Terzic ain't letting go. Welcome to the Velux CHF Final Four, he says. Klein, Janima, Janima, ball to Kanellas. Kanellas had to reach for it. He's going to get a foul this time. Into Brozovic, but 9 metres, says the referee. Still great defending. Marguč steps out high. Still no one at home for Kiel. Three-goal turnaround. Duvniak fouled on the way through. Kiel losing their rhythm. 6 minutes gone, they haven't scored. You don't score for 6 minutes in a Champions League semi-final, then you could be in trouble. They need a goal, and they need them quickly. They've got to break this run. They were on fire at halftime. They won't have wanted halftime to come. But West Brom have come out eager to show them what they're all about. 15-15. Floor wipers are off. Dominic Klein with the ball. Great atmosphere here between two great teams. Janima. No libero now. Hand is up for passive play. Kanellas goes one against one. The block off the defence and out over the sideline. but there was really nothing on there for them at all. Now it's Duvniak, drops the shoulder, ball into the line, stolen again. Ivancic Marguč, Marguč, Kanellas leaves him, and it's an easy goal, and the lead for West Brom. Fourth goal for Marguč, four-goal turnaround, 15-12 down at half-time, and suddenly... Well, you'd be thinking that Alfred should be taking a timeout very shortly to wake his team up. 15-12 at halftime, suddenly it's 16-15. And with 7 minutes gone in the second half, Kiel has not scored a goal. Janima sidesteps Nodge, tries to keep going. And the referee is saying, don't grab his arm. Janima doesn't believe him. The libero is still Ekberg on this side. Nobody at home. They won't want to score another goal here. Won't want to lose another ball. Janima goes sidesteps. Now Duvniak goes along. Great save, Mickler. Rebound, Nodge. Nodge, Palmerson. Palmerson looks. Off comes Shuk. On comes Nielsen. It's wide open in the middle. Now Kiel gets themselves back. Now on comes Vincek. But Mickler has closed up shop in the West Brom goal. And they lead 16-15. Palmerson, Ilić, second line is Gergo Ivancic on the far side. Ball around the corner, no, back to Ilić. Ilić hits Janima. Referee says it's a goal. They wanted attacker foul, they didn't get it. And it's suddenly 17-15. That's a five-goal turnaround. And Duvniak losing his losing the run of himself. And finally, Alfred decides it's time to stop the rot. 8 minutes, and the West Brom team are telling their fans to really get behind them, and Kiel are shell-shocked. Let's listen to the timeout. I was talking to Ico Romero earlier today. I was interviewing him for some behind-the-scenes stuff, and he said it's a really interesting thing. In the first final they were in when they lost to Kiel, they were like 5 or 6 goals ahead. And he said, we kind of thought, oh, we were looking, there's only 10 minutes on the clock. And he said that time took forever to finish as Kiel started to come back. He said when they won the second time in 2011, they said, OK, we're a few goals up. We keep going another goal ahead, another goal ahead, another goal ahead. And that's really what West Brom have to do here, they have to just keep it. And you heard Nielsen saying it there, step by step, step by step. Here comes Ekberg. Ekberg, Vujan. Vujan, one against one. Tries to turn, held up by Nodge. Vincek with the ball, plays it to Duvniak. They need a goal. I've said it before, they need it quickly. Vujan goes, held up, ball into Vincek. That's the goal, that's the score. And this time Vincek adds up, or Vujan adds a little bit of pace to the attack. Fourth goal for Vincek, and it's 17-16. Palmerson, well, there's a bit of something going on in there between Kanellas and Nielsen. Timeout called. And the referee says, hey, come on, guys. Let's be cool. Here it is again. That's the pass into Vincek. That's a great goal.
Lance Zavina, final four.
Ivancic. Ilić Palmerson. Nodge. Deep, deep, deep on the right. Can't even see him. It's Marguč. Palmerson, same movement. Ilić tries to play it. Someone might be in trouble in the middle. No, they allow the ball to play. Nodge, Nodge against Kanellas, tries to turn him, great defending, 9 metre ball. Referee was thinking about blowing it earlier for a foul, I think, on Ilić, but decided not to, let the ball play on. He's in the centre now, Palmerson on the left-back position. Kiel want passive play, or at least their fans do. Ball into Nielsen, nothing, says the referee. Palmerson comes over to ask him, and he says, I've already blown the whistle. Ilić. Ball. Oh, it's a beautiful pass, but the whistle had already gone, and a beautiful goal. Nielsen's disgusted. You know why I love Andy Nielsen? Plays with a smile on his face. Up goes Ilić! Makes no mistake, near post pass land in. Landin gets the ball out. 6 goals, Illich. 18-16 to score. Keel running at a puff here. Look at that. Brozovic sucked into a middle that wasn't there. Vujin, one against Shoup. And you can just feel that the step up in intensity of defence from West Brom, really, since the end of the second half, they're just working so much harder together. Good movement, closing off avenues, blocking shots, everything. Really good to see. Keel has to find an answer. They can't find one yet. Vujin hit by Ivancic. Ball into Vincek. Vincek turns. He's fouled. Should have probably turned the other way. Maybe didn't fancy it. Shoup and Terzic got a hold of him and held him up. They play it again. Vujin. Ekberg goes into the line. And this time again. Oh, they've called a tacker foul. I cannot believe it. Because in the end, Ekberg's shirt is being torn off him. They've called it again. Stop it, says the referee. Well, I mean, the game is going to descend into farce. It was obvious that Ekberg's shirt was being ripped off him as he runs across the line. Then they give an attacker foul. Then they see that, which is an attacker foul, and decide that's enough. I mean, Notch does go down a little bit easily, but he goes in with his shoulder. That's really good reading of the game from Nodge to come across and step into his way. There's the decision I'm talking about. Look at Ekberg's shirt being dragged off him by Shoup. And that is not an attacker foul. Well, here comes Vincek. Vujin. Duvniak. Kanielas. Ball is to Dominic Klein. Foul. And the referees are getting a bit antsy out there with the players. Because Dominic says, listen, I'm sorry. The referee gave him a mouthful, that's for sure. Right, here we go. Vujin held up by Shoup. I should have said he gave him an earful. And Vincek, it's going to be hand for passive play soon. It's coming. Oh, ball in around the corner. Kanielas is losing the run of himself out there. They need Dissinger on, and they need him on quickly. Because Kanielas is just not doing it in their biggest games again. Ah, but Illich and Nielsen are on, Shoup and Terzic are off. Well, Vesprem seems to be getting a lot of time to make their calls here. Aaron seems to be holding the ball for about 10 seconds there. Illich, Palmerson, one-on-one with Vujin. Ball to Illich. Wow, great steal, Kanielas. What did I just say about him? I take it all back. Ball to Kanielas again. Bounces it, loses it over the top. Vincek! What a goal! The man I just said needed to be hauled off. Not only intercepts, but then plays a sumptuous over-the-shoulder pass to Vincek. 17-18. And just when you think West Brom are going to pull away, Keel do something like that. And they're not playing well. But now they've scored two in the second half. West Brom have scored six. Ball Illich. Illich hit by Janima. Both of them go down. It was at Ekberg. Both of them go down. It was Ekberg. Here we see it again. Good closing down by Ekberg. Attacker foul. Ball. Beautiful ball. Easy goal. And they keep putting it near post past Landin, and he keeps giving it to them. Second goal for Gergo Ivancic. Far too easy. Look at that from Illich. Makes the goal. And Ivancic scores it. 19-17. Palmerson takes a break, and Terzic goes over to his side. On the number two position over there. And on this near side, Illich stays on the defence. Vujin, Dissinger. Dissinger takes the shot, but he's fouled. Great defending, by the way, from Illich there. And from Gergo Ivancic, who didn't need to come in and help him. So there was no out ball to Ekberg. So, Brozovic on the line. Dissinger! Ah, easy save. Needed to go near post in that one. On comes Sulic, off comes Shoup. Well, it's all changed at the moment. Let me just check. Off comes Terzic. Sulic is on. On comes Chema. It's Chema in the centre now for West Brom. It is Ekberg, Kanielas, Brozovic, Dissinger, Duvniak and Dominic Klein for Keel in their defence. They're playing from left to right, all in white with the gold trim. Haven't seen much from Duvniak today, I have to say. Hasn't really shown what he can do. Illich, oh, Illich, lovely ball to Nodge. Nodge hit, ball down at the feet of Chamber, manages to pick it up. They keep the ball playing, play on, says the referee. No pass of play yet, will it come soon? That's beautiful! Oh, he's missed the sitter, 7 metres for a push on Sulich. I think he might have got it right. I think he might have got it right, you know.
We have a penalty shot for Vesprin.
Well, if that's a push, I thought it was a push initially, but if that's a push, well, I think we're in trouble in handball. 17-19, Kiel losing by two. Margut steps forward against Landin. Landin needs to start stopping a few now. Oh, he does! Rebound, Duvniak. What a save, Landin, when you need him. The big Dane is there. Or should I call him the great Dane? Dissinger, Vujin goes alone, back to Duvniak, he goes alone, ball out to the wing to Ekberg, back to Duvniak, ball is moving, and they slow it down, oh no, Vujin decides to go again, goes for the shot, oh, Vujin out of nothing, four, just decides there might be a little gap, and he gets a googly, near post past Mickler, Mickler wasn't expecting it, yeah, that's all you can call it, a googly, look at it. Oh, 18-19. 10 seconds to go. They have a chance to make it three, and suddenly it's one. And Vujin, when Duvniak is not doing it, Vujin stepping to the fore. Chema, switch with Nodge. Nodge with Illich. Illich blocked and out over the end line. Dissinger with the block. And look at Duvniak. He wants to concentrate more on playing than winding up the crowd. 19-18. Illich waits for Ivancic to move. He doesn't. Chema takes it. One against one. Now, beautiful ball. Right down the throat of Landin. Poor shot. He's looking. He finds Duvniak. Duvniak is looking. Oh, Duvniak. It's the curse of the commentator today. Get Kanielis off. He plays the pass. Get Duvniak off. He scores this goal. Number five in the game. Even Stevens, 19-19. Would you credit that at the start of the second half? Well, I cannot. Yeah, well, I can believe it, because when these two teams meet, you just never know. It's magic. Little switch with Illich. How much power has Illich got left in that arm? Ah, oh, beauty! Save! He's on the 6 metre line. What a ball, Nodge. Look at this. Oh, that's incredible. That's incredible. Two magnificent saves. If you don't count the one from Illich, make that three if you do. In a row from Landin, and suddenly the game changes again. Oh, Dissinger's in trouble. No foul. Gerrits, Gaspar Maragucci all alone. Scores near post past Landin. 20-19 and the fifth goal for him. Great defending from Sulich. Great defending from Sulich. Brilliant defending from Sulich. And Gaspar Maragucci picks up the pieces and scores the goal. 20-19. And Laszlo Nagy gets a break. 47 minutes and 16 seconds into the game. He gets his first break. And he's down in the liquids like there's no tomorrow. So the defense. That was the pass to Dissinger. So it is now Illich and Schuch in the centre block, Sulich in the two, Maragucci outside him, here comes Dominic Klein, up goes Vujin! Vujin! What? Who is this man? Marco Vujin out of nowhere, 5 goals, 20-20, Chema goes alone against Vincek, 9 metre ball, says the referee. Oh, you gotta say they just. It's magical to watch two teams like this who want to play handball, who want to score, who want to play it in the right way. That's the only way I can say it. This is a game that kids can watch and really appreciate and love. Illich, another shot and another block. And was it Disco Christian again? It was. Here it is again. Look at him, shirt being pulled off him by Sulic, and he still gets the block on. But Vespren have the ball. Vujin going crazy. Brozovic going crazy. Chema, one-on-one with brilliant defending by Kanellas. Brilliant defending. It is Kanellas. It is not Igor Anic. For sure it's Kanellas. Great defending on Chema. Ilic, oh, hold down. It's okay. He was going down early, says the referee, and Vincek's delighted with that. Timeout. Duvniak winding up the crowd again. Dominic Klein winding up the crowd again. 20-20, floor wipers on. Well, is that actually Aaron Palmerson? Or not Aaron Palmerson, Alfred Gislason. I've never seen him so animated. He's really enjoying this game today. If he wins today, and maybe wins the EHF Final Four, it will go down as perhaps his greatest achievement ever as a coach. Maybe even surpassing the one he won at Magdeburg. Ah, there's a lot to go, yeah. Ilic, hit, stolen, but it's a foul. 2 minute suspension for Duvniak, is it, or for Kanellas? It's for someone. Ilic has got an awful bang off. I think it was Duvniak who got it. No, it's Kanellas. Kanellas pushes him in midair. Watch it again. No, I think Ilic buys that one, I have to be honest. It is Kanellas who gets the 2 minute suspension. And just to add a little spice to that story, that win for Magdeburg was against, yeah, you guessed it, Vespren. Yeah. So 6-5 and a chance for Vespren to pull even further ahead in this pulsating game. Here's Sulic on the wraparound. Dominic Klein steps out, but cuts off both wing and halfback. Nodge on his own. Ilic. They want the handful pass of play. The crowd gets it. Ilic shot off over the sideline. Blocked by big Paddy Vincek. The blonde bomber in there. Chema. Ball to Nodge. Nodge behind the back. Attacker foul! Attacker foul! What are you saying? Oh, Nodge thought he had them all. Ends up. Plays it in. Oh, is there anything left to see in this game? Here he comes. Here comes Nodge. It's an attacker foul. Dissinger. Disco Dissinger. Oh, playing his heart out. A couple of weeks ago, he was walking on one leg. Now, suddenly, here he is in the Velux CHF Final Four semi-final. Dissinger one-on-one with Sulic, goes alone, holds on to Sulic, Sulic holds on to him, 9 metre ball. Ekberg is waiting for something to happen, but at the moment he's just running up and down with a black jersey on him. Here comes Vujin again, he's hit by Terzic, gives the little theatrical dive. Here comes Brozovic, Vujin! Oh, great save, Mickler! Great save, Mickler. That was whizzing past him, you know. And he gets a hand to it. Still 20-20. And it's Chema. Chema, someone take a timeout so I can get some water. This game is non-stop. Unbelievable. And if you look along the benches, every player is playing every pass, playing every movement. Chema, Ilic, it's open. Wing is open on the far side. Ball in, Sulic. Sulic falls over and gets a penalty. He's expecting the hit. The hit doesn't come. Now the referee says Vincek is inside defending. Let's look again. There's Vincek. There's Sulic. Oh, my goodness me. Oh, my goodness me. They won't want to see that again. And Sulic then explains, oh, you were inside when I fell over your foot. That I stuck my foot around your foot to fall over. Classic. Ilic. Landin. Goal, Ilic, 21-20. Oh, seven. I'll tell you, I'm not a referee, but even I could see that Sulic fell over a 6 meter line there.
So far in this game, seventh goal from Momir Ilic.
Well, he's the top scorer in the game. Okay, Landin now, 38%. Mickler, 38%. That last save from Vujin. Doesn't look much, but it's one of those class ones. Here's Vu Yin, open again. Oh, nailed by Nodge, but it's a good defensive tackle, says the referee. 8.5 minutes left in the game. One goal advantage for West Brom. Here comes Dominic Klein again. Here comes Vu Yin again. Vu Yin is hit. Ball to Dissinger. Reverse pass to Vinček. Vinček alone. Plays it to... No! Tacker foul called. Ball to Chema. Chema alone. Plays it to Sulic. Sulic loses it. Vinček picks it up. Here comes Dubniak. Oh, Dubniak looks left, looks right. Eventually finds Vinček left. Oh, comedy of errors. Comedy of errors. What a game of handball. Let me just remind you, at home, West Brom won 27-25 against this Kiel team. And with 1 minute on the clock, it was 25-25. Then, Kiel... I know what you're feeling, Peter. And then Kiel won the reverse fixture, 25-24. And with a minute to go, it was... With 30 seconds to go, it was 24-24. This game is going down to the wire. Just under 8 minutes remaining. 21-20, West Brom lead. Kiel in control of the ball. Dubniak, reverse pass, Dissinger, wide, goalkeeper's ball, nice play. Rune Dampke on in place of Dominic Klein. What will that mean? Terzic in the halfback now, didn't come off. Ilić is waiting, Šuk has to sit down. Now Ilić is on in place of Terzic. And Sulic stays on the line. How important will that penalty call be at the end of the game? Well, you just never know. Jamie Nodge, Nodge Marguč. Now, look at the defence in there against Sulic, but it's in the middle now with Chema. The hand has got to go for pass of play soon. They're not going anywhere. Still not coming. They're wasting a lot of time. Chema, Ilić, block, two blocks, pick up, Rune Dampke, Dubniak, Dubniak all alone. Ekberg scores! What a game of handball! What a counter-attack goal! 3-3! Oh my goodness me! Look at this! Under that pressure, Ekberg knows to make the run. Oh! Oh, it's timeout call. Thank you very much, Sammy Sabate. 21-21. Let's take a break. Do not go anywhere. Well, look at those two men there. One starting off his head coaching career, one who's been... Oh, that's what he says. Keep your mouth closed. Good advice for all players listening to their coach. What's the rule? Rule number one, the coach is always right. Rule number two, even when the coach is wrong, see rule number one. So, Alfred Gieslassen, in these key moments, 6 minutes 30 remaining in the game, how much will his experience tell? That is the big key. Okay, 21-21. Let's have a look again. Gergo, Ivancic, Ilić, Palmerson, Nodge, Marguč and Nielsen on the line. They've changed Sulic. Oh, Ilić is all alone. Now it's Nodge. Captain's goal, maybe. Loses it, gets away with it. Defense is Ekberg, Kanellas, Brozovic, Dissinger, Dubniak and Rune Dampke, and it's still Landin in goal, still Mikler in goal on the far end. Here is Palmerson. Could he break Alfred's heart? Ilić is alone. Oh, he stepped, didn't he? Ilić to Nodge. Nodge scores second goal of the game. And I think Gilic might have been lucky to get away with steps there, but it really doesn't matter. There we go. That steps all day and all night, but you can't fault that goal from Nodge. Absolutely brilliant. And Gergo takes a seat. And it's Palmerson defending in the one position and on the left. Illich and Shuk in the centre block. Now Duvniak Dissinger. Dissinger, Bouillon is through! Another goal and he's down, he's hurt! He's down, he's hurt! They've called on the medical team. He got a bang on the way through. Watch it again. But Bouillon, he's Mr. Breakthrough today. Here it is again. Oh, Jerzic comes over. And that's one right in the solar plexus. That's a 2-minute suspension and definitely more. No, maybe not. That's a good decision. I think you just go for that there as part of the game. He's just giving a touch on him. But I think he hits him right in the solar plexus and that can hurt.
Equalizer 22-22, Marco Bouillon.
And it's coming to 5 minutes remaining. Well, I don't know about anybody else, but my heart is in my mouth for both of these teams, because after a game like this, nobody deserves to lose. Illich, Nielsen, Nodge, Palmerson. Brozovic one-on-one with Palmerson again. Ball to Illich, and Brozovic does really well. And Canellas, in fairness, I think Palmerson could have gone on his own there. He had Brozovic for pace, decides not to do it, and they slow it down again. 22-22. Palmerson, Illich. Oh, it was open. Rune Dampkin stepped out, missed it. They want more, Keel. They're not going to get it. Oh, what a save! Oh, what a save from Nodge. Land in. Ball breaks. They haven't recovered yet. Here's the ball to Bouillon. He's going alone. Oh, my word, Bouillon. 7 goals in one of the biggest games in his club history. Look at it. Nothing. Illich, no chance. Mickler, no chance. Well, you know, 91 kilometres an hour, the ball whizzes past your head. You're taking your head out of the way. I don't care how professional a goalkeeper you are. Oh, Keel. 23-22. 4 minutes, 15 seconds remaining.
4 minutes, 19 seconds left.
Palmerson, Nodge. Palmerson, Illich, Illich. Oh, beautiful ball. Oh, Illich now hit by Vincek. Ball to Nodge, hit by Brozovic. Fighting for their lives in there, Keel. Vesprem trying everything, moving every which way they can. Switching here, switching there. But always the answer in the white wall. Palmerson, ball to Nielsen. Save, 7 metres. Oh, incredible action now at this stage. And definitely a 7-metre penalty shot. Great save again, Landine, but look at the defence, look at Palmerson, ball around the corner, and there's two men inside, and that's it. Nielsen has no chance to take the shot perhaps he wants to take. Nice, nice block, first of all. He's inside himself, but I think you've got to give that as a 7-metre. All right. Canellas' arm is on him as he goes through. Landine just has a little think, goes back through the playbook in his head. What does Illich do? He's already saved one from him. What can he do? Comes out from the shadow of the crossbar. Oh, he's given him the lob. He's given him the lob. Oh, gets a hand, but Illich buries it. 23-23. Momir, when you need him, scores again for his 8th goal of the game. Oh, very close, but that's the way it goes. Yeah. The fake again. Look. Ah, Landy knows him. He's just about got it past him. They never played together, Akil, of course. At that time, Landine was down in Rhein-Neckarluven. But here's Bouillon again. Here's Disco again. Ball to Bouillon. Back to Dissinger. Bit of... Oh, look at... Bouillon is open one more time. Overplaying it. Oh, what a ball! What a ball! What a goal! What a ball! Dissinger! How many times has he played an assist today? This is miraculous. 24-23. 3, fourth goal, Ekberg, Palmerson. Oh, he's lost it! He's lost it! Unbelievable! Aaron Palmerson loses the simplest of passes. That's the goal, but actually, it's the assist from Dissinger again. The movement of that Kiel team when they're playing is absolutely awe-inspiring. And they just seem to have found another gear right at the moment that you need it. Can they score again here? Here's Dissinger. Dissinger tries to go through. He can't do it. The ball is back on the 9-meter line with Vinček. Plays it. Duvniak. Duvniak, Dissinger, Duvniak. Here's Ekberg. The move that got them so many goals at the start of the game. And down goes, looks like, is it, it's Terzic. And Dissinger, I think, took another bang. That's great defence from Terzic. It's 9 metres. Can't see there. Does he get him in the face? But at this stage, you don't want to win a game based on a decision that it might be 2 minutes unless it's absolutely vitally clear. Rune Dampiker comes off, and it's Fairy Tale Boy comes on. Dominic Klein, the man who scored the winner in Kiel against West Brom. One goal to the good. 24-23, 2 minutes remaining. Dominic Klein, what a ball! Oh, he's got to go through there. Doesn't fancy it. Duvniak goes one-on-one with Palmerson, is it? And Palmerson stops him in his tracks. Good defending from Aaron, making up for his earlier mistake. But Duvniak had a tunnel all the way through to the goal there and played it far too early to Ekberg out there on the right wing. 1 minute, 45 seconds left, and a timeout still in the pocket of definitely Xavi Sabate, and I think two in the pocket of Kiel. Oh, Duvniak! What about that for a goal? What about that for a goal? And a timeout call for West Brom out of nothing, out of nothing. Duvniak, when he could have gone through earlier, decides no. And look at this, how many times? Oh, he walks through the defence. Where were they? Here he goes, drops the shoulder, straight through. Terzic steps out too early. Timeout for West Brom. The buzzer's gone for the timeout, and we are ready to rock and roll with 1 minute and, 1 minute 30 seconds. 1 minute 39 seconds, thank you to the whole speaker there, who lets me know. Okay, West Brom, they've got their strongest team out now. What can they do? Aaron Palmerson. Nodge. Illich, oh, ball back to Sulic, ball to Nodge. Nodge goes up, oh, Nodge scores. Oh, that's a captain's goal. Third goal for him. 1:20 left, one goal game. Well, Kiel can take some time out of the clock here, that's for sure. But Ugalde's gone out in a 5-1 they like to play. Alfred's got his hand in his pocket with the timeout card, which he now places on the table. And you might argue that Laszlo Nagy scored that one a bit too early. Well, let's see. There's still a minute left in the game. A timeout call. What do they play? Well, Alfred has had his say. If you've just joined us, you have missed one of the greatest games of handball I've ever witnessed, and I've seen some games here. A Kiel team that came devoid of many of full fitness, many of the stars not of full fitness, are leading by one with a minute and 1 second remaining in the second half. Ugalde decides to go back into a 6-0 defence. Alfred has called a concept that I don't recognise, that Carsten beside me also doesn't recognise. Let's see what happens. Well, if they score this, they've a great chance to go to the final, but they have to score it. Mickler's in goal. There's a serious wall of red ahead of them. Ball to Dominic Klein. Ball, reverse pass. Duvniak is hit. And it goes out over the sideline. I don't think the referee was going to call a foul there. 40 seconds remaining. Is there another timeout in Gislason's pocket? No, there isn't. He took an early one when they hadn't scored in 8 minutes. What a comeback by Kiel. Dissinger, Vu Yin. They want passive play. Ball to Duvniak. They've got passive play. He goes alone again. One-on-one pass. Illich. Foul. 9-metre ball. And they want everyone sitting down on the Vestbrem bench. So do I, because they're right in front of me. So, ball still with Kiel. 20 seconds remaining. A goal here and the game is over. Dissinger, all alone, waiting for that pass. Can he shoot it? Can he score it? Here's the pass. Here's the shot, well over the end line. 20 seconds left. Can Vestbrem bring this to extra time? Ball to Palmerson. Palmerson hit. Ball stolen. No, winger! Score! What a goal! 5 seconds, yes, four, three, shot, save, rebound, 25-25. Nothing between these two teams. Kiel had it in their hand, and Vestbrem just managed to come back.
Let's go to extra time.
Well, we're going to extra time. Two fives and then penalties. Just got a little look there from Aaron Palmerson, and Dominic Klein went out to steal and in the end left Margooch all alone. Well, maybe he thought he had to do it. It was a chance. Margooch still had to score it. That's a great goal, 25-25. The big question now is, has Kiel still got 10 minutes of handball left in their legs? Vestbrem has the bigger bench, but the coach hasn't tried to use it today. Coach hasn't used it today. He's sticking with the tried and tested. Oh, I actually didn't need another five, another two extra times in this game. But that's what we've got. We're in the Lanxess. Stay with us, because 20,000 fans and all of you around the world, wherever you're watching, you're tuning in right at the moment when the coaches are maybe massaging the legs, massaging the egos, trying to get a bit of extra oxygen to the brain, something, anything, getting liquids on board, players having a little chat with each other, focusing on what they know, focusing on the positives. And right at this moment of time, it will feel to Kiel like they've lost this game, and it will feel to Vestbrem like they've won this game. And that is where psychology comes into this situation, because this team was down and out, two goals to score in a minute and 20 of handball. It's been done, but it's difficult to do, but somehow they came up with the defense to keep Kiel out. And then Kiel with 5 seconds to go, well, they'll think to themselves maybe they could have stopped it, but you gotta hand it to this Vestbrem team. Never down, never out. Well, the referees take the coin toss, and I don't think that Alfred has taken the ball. I think he's changed sides. Well, that's bizarre. He wants to test his defence against Vestbrem. He wants to see whether he puts pressure on them if they don't score the first goal. Well, there's only 10 minutes of handball here, which means that, if Vestbrem score, it puts the pressure right back on Kiel. Hell's bells rings out around the arena. Hell's bells rings out around the arena. But it is hell's bells. Well, there's nothing more can be said about those two halves of handball except that
we're all the fans from Tiami Kiel.
These two teams always produce the goods when they play against each other.
We're all the fans from Vestland.
Well, it seems to me like there's equal amount of Vestland fans and Kiel fans in the arena. That was an incredible roar that went up around the arena. Brozovic just having a word with Bouyin to see exactly what has to happen in the changeover. Xabi Sabate calls his team in some final instructions. Alfred has a look at the notepad to see who's played
let's
what, who's scored
let's
what.
Make some noise. Everybody!
Well, in the end, that Sulic penalty. All right, I know it's easy to say in hindsight because probably there were other decisions, but that was such a clear and obvious dive by Sulic. And you think to yourself, 25-25. And with instant replay, maybe it's one of them. If you're not sure, you come over and just check. That's what it's there for. So Dominic Klein, low fives every one of his teammates, and then comes back to his defensive position on the left wing. And then inside him is Duvniak, centre block, Brozovic and Vincek. Kanellas in the right back position defending, and Ekberg. But basically what the coach said to Brozovic is, look, if the fast break is on, you go. And then if the ball slows down, then you change. So Vujin is waiting to come on in that position. Vesprem attacking, it's Ugalde, Sliskovic in place of Ilic. That's an interesting call, young guy. That's a big moment from Palmerson in the centre, Nodge in the right back, Marguc in the right wing, and Nielsen on the line, and Mickler, who basically has had a great second half, I have to say, stays in goal. Nice save, Landy. Knew where that was going. So Alfred Gieselassen, the old fox, knows exactly what he's doing. Takes the defence, makes them make the shot, makes the save, and suddenly Keeler in control again. Deep to his bottom corner on the right, covers it. And in the second half, yeah, they get the ball. Kanellas in the centre now, and Duvniak. Kanellas goes, little switch with Duvniak. Nodge followed with him, and then Duvniak didn't seem to know what he wanted to do. Kanellas held up by Palmerson. Then he's hit by Terzic, and the referees decide that's nothing. And Terzic actually says, did I hit you in the face? Is it 2 minutes the referees are going to give him? Nope. Well, there it is again. Ball with Duvniak in the centre again. Vujin, Duvniak. Kanellas, the block from Vincek. The block from Vincek. Goes a low save. Went near post. Mickler read it. Two balls near post. Goalkeeper read both. And two saves, no goals. 25-25. Terzic. Sliskovic. Terzic makes his move off. Nielsen stays in on the line. Brozovic is off. And Vujin still defending. Hasn't had a chance to come off. So what will that mean, facing Sliskovic? So Nielsen goes over that side, put pressure on Vujin. No, he's coming on the wraparound. Here he comes. Ball to Nodge. Now Palmerson is facing Vujin. What's Vujin going to do? Holds him up twice. And free throw to Palmerson, which he takes and plays back to Sliskovic. He faces him again, goes again. Blocked by Vincek. But foul, said the referee. 9 metre one more time. So, Palmerson, Nodge! Nodge doesn't fancy it! Nodge doesn't fancy it! Nodge, ball to Palmerson! What a shot! What a goal, Aaron Palmerson! 26-25, third goal for him!
25-26, Aaron Palmerson!
Oh, well, around Vujin. They didn't want Vujin defending. He turned his back on the shot. Vinček now looks for Duvniak, finds Duvniak. One-on-one in the centre with Šuk. Oh, great goal. Šuk, did you see what Šuk did there? Nothing, because he didn't know what Duvniak was going to do. Seventh goal for Duvniak, and he's really come into the game in the second half. 26-26, third minute gone in extra time. And that's the first period of extra time. Here comes Liskovic on the run. Marguč on Nodge, tries to go against Dominic Klein. Dominic Klein, such a good defender. Nodge just didn't know what to do there. As Nodge run out of energy here. Here's Palmerson, Sliskovic. Oh, he's hit, loses it. Dominic Klein rips it from his hand. Duvniak looks, finds, oh, what a block! What a block! That's free out! Why did Duvniak try that ball? Oh, well, you can think all you want. He saw it open. Great defense, Klein at one end, and then here's Klein. Look at this, what a steal. And then, oh, it's Palmerson. Oh, Palmerson scores a goal, and then, well, I don't see the foul there, to be honest. Game on. Nodge, plays it on to Sliskovic. Sliskovic, hit, but scores. Ah, oh, Duvniak's disgusted with Brozovic there, and perhaps with Landin as well. First goal for Sliskovic, 27-26. Dominic Klein goes into the centre now. Rune Damke out on the left wing. He moves in second line. Here's Dominic Klein. Ball to Vujin. Vujin is hit by Šuk. He looks at Šuk, gives him the dirty look, dirtiest look you've ever seen. 25 seconds left in this first period of extra time. Oh, what a save, Mikler. Oh, really quick shot, underarm from Vujin. Seen him go in. Didn't happen this time. Can Veszprém take a two-goal lead? There's still 11 seconds left. Ugalde's calling them to play it faster. 5 seconds. Four. Sliskovic. Oh, what a goal! Two goals for him. Two-goal lead for Veszprém. Kiel are on the brink of going out of the VeloCHF Final Four. Oh, Sliskovic, clever coaching. Ilitch's arm was gone. They brought on the young lad, and look at the power he's generating after 65 minutes of a game. Difficult for the goalkeeper to stop that power. So, Kiel, 28-26 down. Five-goal turnaround overall. Remember, they were leading 15-12 at half-time. And at full-time, I think it was 25-25. Just got to check that. Xavi Sabate gives some more clues to his team as to what they want to do. Let's listen to him for a while. Well, the one plus for Kiel is that they're in control of the ball. Start of the second period of extra time. Two goals down. Dissinger comes back on. Brozovic stays on the line. And Duvniak goes to the centre. So, the strongest possible team he's got at this moment in time, Alfred Gieslason puts on the court. What can they do? Brozovic. Ball to Dissinger, Vujin to Duvniak. Save again! Marguč again! Does he see Ugalde? Doesn't need him! What a save! Landin! Oh, what a save from Marguč! Oh, they needed it so badly! Dissinger goes alone, held up by Nodge and held up by Terzic. Referees want the ball back into the 9-meter line in the middle. Oh my goodness me, what a game. What a save by Landin. Great save, Mikler. Great save, Landin. Duvniak, Ekberg, dissing a reverse pass to Duvniak, drops the shoulder, goes again. Palmerson has him in his pocket. Ball on the nine. Duvniak, Dissinger, Brozovic comes over this far side. Dissinger one-on-one with Nodge. Can he play the ball? No, he can't. Wasting time. They're 1 minute and 10 seconds. They need a goal. They need it quickly. Ball is lost. No foul! No foul, says the referee. I can't believe it! Oh my goodness me, what a terrible decision. Third goal for Ugalde. And that, you would say, is that. Ugalde breaks down. He's to play the whistle. And, they're not coming back from this now. Duvniak hit again on the way through. Time called by the referee. Everybody up, he says. And Dissinger's off and Cornelius is on. And the floor wipers are on. Well, I didn't see that again. But it looked to me like someone got one in the face. Now, of course, you can't always tell. And certainly not from my angle. Sometimes a player on the bench is just in my way. But this looks very much like it's Vesprem's game, unless Kiel do something unbelievable. Ball to Vujin. Vujin can't break past Terzic. Running out of steam, Kiel are. Cornelius, Vujin, stolen. Great steal, Ugalde. Ugalde breaks. And Vesprem are on cloud nine because there's no way Kiel is coming back from this. And, Alfred, he tried everything, the wily old fox. But in the end, he just didn't have, perhaps, the personnel to carry off a victory. And they were so close to it. Almost stolen. Lost again. No, one back. Palmerson again. Sliskovic steps. No travelling, says the referee. Yes, it was, says the referee. They lose the ball. But there's only 2.5 minutes left with three goals to get for Kiel. Cornelius, what can he do? Goes up, goes one against one, loses the ball, is fouled, and the ball comes back out to the 9-metre line again. Duvniak, Vujin. Duvniak blocked, stolen by Sliskovic. Ball to Ugalde. And Kiel, well, it's all over. Fourth goal for Ugalde. Four-goal lead for Vesprem, and they are already celebrating the win. And why wouldn't they? Because with 1 minute 45 seconds left, it's going to be Kiel against Paris Saint-Germain tomorrow in the third place game. Noka and Alfred come face to face after all these years. The two Kiel legends. Shot by Vujin is in. 1:25 left on the clock. Eighth goal for Vujin. But a three-goal deficit just isn't going to be picked up with the amount of time that's left on the clock. Kiel come out high to try and win it, but Vesprem are just playing the ball around. They know there's nothing to lose here. They know they can't lose here. Palmerson shoots and scores. 31-27, fourth goal for him. And really, when the chips were down, Aaron Palmerson really played a great game. 45 seconds remaining. The Kiel team will probably be just delighted to get off the court at this stage. But they have to play it out to the end. Cornelius, Vujin fakes one, but there's nothing here now. The game is just, it's just petering out into, a little bit farcical now because they've got to play the last 15 seconds. Ball into the line is scored by Ekberg. The goal will count, will go on as Champions League score. But with 7 seconds remaining, the referees are just going to let the time tick down. 4-3, 2-1, and Vesprem will go to the gold medal match tomorrow, having defeated Kiel in a game that had just about everything. The players shake hands with the referees, shows how sportsmanlike they were. Nodge just at vital times. But the defence of West Brom stood up when it needed to stand up, and Ekberg cannot believe it. How many semi-finals has he lost now? West Brom go forward to the gold medal game. Keel put up a great fight, and up until extra time, that game was an absolute corker. And at that stage, well, you have to look at certain things, but I think you could be, it's fair to say that either of these teams could have won, but in the end, I think West Brom, over the course of the season, just about deserve it. And over the course of the extra time today, just about deserve it. Tough game for everybody. Landin finishes with 34%, but Mickler turned the game in the second half for sure. He ended up on 32%, but made some valuable saves. And their counter-attack and their defence is really, really good. Šiškovič, 2 from 2 in extra time, made a big, big difference. So it's onwards and upwards for West Brom now. They go to the gold medal match, as I said. They will play Kielce of Poland. Xavi Sabata, in his maiden season as the coach of West Brom, leads them to the final to face that other wily old fox from Spain, Talant Ujubayev. But before that, tomorrow afternoon at 3:15 Central European time, it will be the game for the third place medal, that is PSG against THW Kiel. Devastation for Kiel, but they go back with their heads held high, knowing they did everything they could have done. We're going to take a little break from the commentary duties now, but hopefully we'll have an interview with you in just a few seconds' time.
Gasper, leave that scarf alone. Tell us about that. That was the most amazing game of handball I think I've ever seen.
It was a really, really tough game. Tough fight, the whole 60 minutes. 1 minute until the end, we were losing 2 goals, but we kept fighting. We equalized, and in the extra time, the momentum was just with us, and we completely overrun them.
Is that what it is in the end? Is it just momentum, or did Xavi say something to you? Because Šiškovič came on, and his arm just looked fresher. I mean, there were so many different variables in that extra time.
Yeah, Ivan scored two important goals. He almost didn't play the whole match, came off the bench, so congratulations to him. Then Christian Ogal, the two fast break goals, so that was it. And the defense, of course, our defense was amazing.
And what about Mikler in that second half? I mean, Ilinović does okay, but Mikler comes on, and at key times, he makes key saves.
Yes, it's true. We have two very good goalkeepers. One time, Ilinović said, today it was Mikler, and it was also a very, very important factor.
Okay, now, you're the only guys who know. You play Chielsea tomorrow. That's going to be tough.
Of course, they beat Paris. The curious thing is we have never played against them, so I'm looking forward to it.
Okay, thanks for talking to us. Well
thank
done.
You. Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll get straight started. Welcome to the second semi-final press conference of the day for the Velux EHF Final Four, which match today, very exciting, went to extra time, which MVM Veszprém won 31-28, 25-25 full time, but Kiel leading 15-12 at half time. I'd like to introduce, first of all, our guests. On my right, Alfred Gislason and Dominic Klein. On my left, Javier Sabata and Gaspar Marguch from Veszprém. We'll start with the coach of the winning team, Veszprém. Javier, tell us your reaction, your feelings after such an exciting game.
Good evening to everybody. First of all, I would like to congratulate to Kiel and especially to the coach, Mr. Alfred Gislason, because it was a Kiel play a great match. It's clear that they had the real option to win the match when at the end, 1 minute and a half before finish the match, they were leading 2 goals. And I would like to congratulate to all our players for one more time the effort and belief in the difficult moments like they believe and like they fight during all the season in some very hard situations. About the match, I think that in the first half, the last 5 minutes, it was very important when they lead 3 goals. In the second half, I think that we will play better, especially in defense, and our goalkeeper was very good, Mikler. We could run, but Kiel is a very good team. And they recovered the difference. They were leading until the end, but we believe that we can win. And with the lucky and with the belief, we beat today against one great team. And the last thing I would like to congratulate to all the players, but today, I think that Sliskovic was amazing one more time, and it was very important for us.
Thank you. Alfred, your reaction to tonight's game?
Yeah, good evening. Thank you, Javi. I think, first of all, it was an extremely good handball game. And it was a spectacular game, I think, in many ways. Of course, I'm very, very proud of my team, how they played today. We started well in defense. We started also with a great goalkeeping from Lundin. And in attack, we played, I think, well also, leading with 3 goals at halftime, and then starting the second half, we were playing too slow, we were making too many errors, and then I think Veszprém made 5 goals in a row. After that, I think that my team played a fantastic handball. We played tactically really, really well, and in the end, leading with 2 goals, we don't make the right decisions in the end, and and that's why we almost invite West Brom to the overtime. So, but well, in the overtime we didn't have any. Well, we have of course not a huge bench of players who can help us at that situation. So it was a little, a very tired team that I think we lost. Lost the game, the overtime, well, a little too easily, but it was a huge pity because in normal time, I think we deserved to win. But we made some gifts in the end, and that brought us on the still playing against 3 and 4 tomorrow. Congratulations, I wish you the best of luck for the final, and West Brom is a fantastic club who has been fighting for this for many, many times, and I wish you the best.
Thank you. Gasper, you were down by 3 goals at half-time. What did your coach say to you in the locker room in the half-time break to make West Brom turn the game around?
Hi to everybody. Nothing special that they came to this lead at the end of the halftime. Most of the first halftime it was, we were equally good. Just in the end they ran away a little bit, but we believed that we could win this game. The second half was goal for goal. In the last minute they were leading 2 goals. I think almost everybody thought that it was over already, but we kept believing and equalized with a little bit of luck, of course, but we kept on fighting. And after, in the extra time, I think the momentum was a little bit with us because we almost lost the game and turned it around. And of course, I think their moral was a little bit down in the extra time because they almost won the game during regular time. So we played good defense and just kept running in the extra time, and in the end we were better, but I just want to say that it was a really, really good game, exciting, interesting, very good handball, and I really believe that the fans enjoyed it.
Thank you very much. Dominic, your reaction to today's game, one of your last games for Kiel, how do you feel?
It's not quite easy, the fourth statement, everything was said. We have to be proud about our fans, that they come into the whole weekend. But it was the 6th times for us as THW Kiel, and I want to win 3rd time here in Cologne. But yeah, it was very, very worst day for me and for the team.
Thank you, Dominic. So now I can open up the floor to any questions from the media. Does anybody have a question? Okay, I'd like to thank our panel guests tonight and thank you for attending, and we'll see you again tomorrow for another day of great handball.